Hello everyone, today's our topic is adenoids and homeopathic treatment. Adenoids are small masses of tissue located at the back of the throat behind the nose. They are the part of lymphatic system and play a role in trapping germs that enter the body through the nose and mouth. Adenoids can become enlarged and cause various health issues, especially in children. Common problems associated with enlarged adenoids includes difficulty in breathing, snoring, sleep apnea, ear infection, and recurrent sinusitis. The homeopathic treatment is one of the alternative therapies that some people consider for adenoid-related issues. Homeopathy is based on the principle of like cures like, where highly diluted substances that would cause symptoms in a healthy person are used to stimulate the body's natural healing process. Now we'll see the medicines for the adenoids. The first one is a Calcarea carb. This remedy is often considered when adenoids are enlarged, leading to breathing difficulties, snoring, and recurrent ear infections. Individuals who may benefit from Calcarea carb are often chilly. Calcarea patient is fair, fat, flabby, and perspiring. Children, they crave eggs and eat undigestible things. The next medicine is Calcarea iode or iodide of lime. Flabby children subject to cold, useful remedy in scrofulous affections, especially enlarged glands. Useful medicine in tonsillitis and adenoids. The next medicine is Baryta carb. This remedy is associated with adenoid hypertrophy in children who have delayed physical and mental development. These children might also experience frequent throat infections and have the difficulty in concentrating. The next medicine is Baryta iode. This remedy is sometimes considered when there is a glandular swelling, including adenoids, along with throat discomfort and frequent throat infections. Quinsy acts on lymphatic system, increase leukocytosis. The next medicine is Ergrafis. This remedy is commonly used for adenoid issues, particularly when there are frequent throat infections, difficulty in breathing through the nose, and tendency to catch cold easily. Throat and ear troubles with tendency to free discharges from mucous membrane. Next medicine is Kali bichromicum. This remedy might be considered when there is a thick, stringy nasal discharge, which can cause discomfort and difficulty in breathing through the nose. Next medicine is a Lamina minor. Lamina minor is often used when there is a feeling of obstruction in the nasal passage, difficult breathing, and a tendency to breathe through the mouth. Atrophic rhinitis, loss of smell, crust, and mucopurulent discharge from the nose, putrid taste on rising in the morning, worse in heavy rains. The next one is Sambugus nigra. This remedy might be helpful when there is a difficult breathing through the nose, especially at night, leading to snoring and waking up suddenly with a sensation of suffocation, profuse sweat accompanying many affections. Child awakens suddenly, nearly suffocating, sits up, turns blue, cannot expire. Another medicine is Mephitis. Now the next medicine is tuberculinum. Tuberculinum is a deep acting remedy that may be considered when there is a strong family history of tuberculosis and the individual have symptoms related to adenoid enlargement and respiratory issues, desire for cold milk, in general better in open air. Next medicine is a Tucrium M. This remedy is sometimes considered for chronic nasal congestion and nasal polyps which can be associated with adenoid issues. Individuals who may benefit from this remedy often have a foul smelling in the nose and may frequently picks at the nose. A remedy for first importance in chronic nasal catarrh with atropine. Large offensive crust and clinkers, loss of sense of smell. Next medicine is Thuja. Thuja is often considered when there is a history of repeated infections, including adenoid infections or adenoids, along with history of vaccination. Psychotic remedy. It is a king of psychotic remedy. Now we will see the concluding part. In homeopathy, the selection of specific remedy is based on an individual's unique symptoms, constitution, and overall health. There is no one size fits all the approach as homeopathy treats each person as an individual. Therefore, it's important to consult a qualified homeopathic practitioner who can assess your case and prescribe a remedy tailored to your specific conditions. Thank you.